You ever met somebody who is rich and wealthy, but you wouldn't know it from their appearance or their lifestyle? There are many people who have more than enough money to live lavishly, yet not all the wealthy live lavish lifestyles. Some are very humble and live modestly and practice great generosity. I knew such a person in my previous parish. I think I preached about her one time. She was an elderly lady, never married, who lived in an apartment near the church. Not only did she volunteer at Catholic Charities every day, but she even wore clothing that she purchased from their thrift store. And when you saw her, you would think she was among the poorest of the poor. When she died, she left the parish about $600,000. And she had over $1 million in stocks and bonds when she died. I was shocked when I discovered the extent of her wealth. Because of her humility and her hidden generosity, I have no doubt that she found her way to heaven when she died. But Jesus warns that the rich will have difficulty entering God's kingdom. Perhaps Jesus knows that riches and wealth can create greed and selfishness. In biblical times, being rich implied that you must be close to God. But Jesus tells us that this is not necessarily the case. If we look to some current examples, even in our own society, of people who have gone after material wealth, we will see that they often end up in a bad state, driven by greed, to break laws, to mistreat people until they lose it all. So perhaps this is why Jesus told the rich man in yesterday's gospel to give up his possessions. Maybe Jesus knew that these would be a stumbling block for this man who wanted to follow him. It's not that money or material things are bad in and of themselves. Rather, it is the desire for these things that can cause a person to lose his or her way. We must learn that anything we have in terms of wealth or riches may be the result of our hard work, but are only made possible by God. If a person works hard and obtains some level of financial comfort, that's wonderful. But then comes the responsibility to share that comfort with others. If anything, material wealth should be seen as a vehicle to make life a little more bearable for others. St. John Chrysostom, who lived in the 4th century, wrote the following: "Not to share one's wealth with the poor is to steal from them and to take away their livelihood. It is not our own goods which we hold, but theirs." It's pretty strong language in the 4th century to suggest that the riches and materials we have really belong to the poor. This isn't a political theory or an economic theory. It's the gospel that proposes justice and love. And it is a matter of our own salvation that we be willing to share our resources with those who are in